measurement, which includes area and perimeter, surface area, volume, things that you are familiar with. But before we can talk about those topics, we have to first revise the theorem of Pythagoras. So all you need to know in the theorem of Pythagoras this year in grade 9 is really just a revision of what you did last year in grade 8. You're using the theorem of Pythagoras to determine the unknown side length in right triangles. So you might get a picture that looks like this, where you're given two of the sides, but we don't know the third one. And there are lots of different ways that we could ask you this question. But basically what I want you to get out of this diagram is that you use Pythagoras when you know two lengths and you need to determine the third one. By now you should have watched the Math Antics, the Pythagorean Theorem video, in which you revised the Pythagorean Theorem up to minute 8:20 or whatever I told you to do. What I'd like you to do now is open your textbooks to page 183, and I'm asking you in pencil to label in your textbook on the diagrams themselves. I want you to label the hypotenuse C of each triangle and the two legs A and B. It doesn't matter which one is A and which one is B, as long as they're the two shorter sides. You're going to do this for 3, 4, 6, 10, 11, 13, 17, and 18. Pause the video now while you do that. In our first example, we're going to use those labels that you just drew on your diagrams. And some of them we're going to do as examples here in the video, and others you'll do for homework. So your labels, you should have labeled the longest side C. I often label that first. It's the easiest one to see the hypotenuse because it's always opposite to the right angle. Then it doesn't matter from there which one you labeled A or B, just as long as it's the two shorter sides. We then use our Pythagoras statement that we learned in the Math Antics video, A squared plus B squared equals C squared. But now there's a catch, because this triangle has a specific name. This triangle's vertices, or the corners, are labeled A, B, and C. So this triangle suddenly has a specific name, triangle ABC. So we need to now use that in our Pythagoras statement. So I need to substitute in side A is named BC. Side B, its name is AC, and side C, its name is AB. So now, if you remember from last year in grade 8, the named line and the reason, Pythagoras, is where you get your marks. So you have to be very specific. If the triangle has a name, triangle ABC in this case, you must use this line where you call it by its name. From there, we're going to substitute in the numbers. So side BC is 20, AC is 15, and AB is what we're trying to find out. I use my calculator to simplify. And now we know that the inverse operation of a square is to take the square root. So I'm going to square root both sides. And the square root of 625 gives me 25 millimeters. Now I'm happy there, but lots of teachers will tell you you need to swap it around so that the AB is in the front. To me, it doesn't really matter. Don't forget the unit of millimeters. Let's look at number 13 from the same exercise. Now you've already labeled the sides A, B, and C. So I start with C first because it's opposite to the right angle. And then I label my two shorter sides, A and B. It doesn't matter which one you chose. My next step is to write down the general Pythagoras' theorem like you learned in the Math Antics video. A squared plus B squared equals C squared. And now I've put my reason Pythagoras here because, unlike the previous question, I don't have any labels on my vertices. So I don't have any letters here giving me a specific name. And if I can't be specific, then I just have to use the general a squared plus b squared equals c squared. But be careful, as soon as you have labels there, you have to use them. Okay, so let's substitute in. The a is what we're trying to find out, but they've told me that it's called y. So we're going to substitute in y there for side a. Side b is equal to 96. And my hypotenuse side C is equal to 100. Notice that in my Pythagoras statement, I always use a plus, and a plus when I substitute. This is because the theorem of Pythagoras states that the sum of the square of the two shorter sides is equal to the square of the longest side. So that word sum has to be tied to my reason, Pythagoras, which means that you have to have a plus sign. Okay, if you use 100 squared minus 96 squared, you're not going to get the mark necessarily. Okay, so I expanded here. You could just say 100 squared minus 96 squared, but instead I've multiplied those out using my calculator. I take 9,216 across to the other side and change the sign to a minus. And then when I simplify, I need to take the square root of 784, which is equal to 28. Now, remember, if there's no unit of centimeters or meters or millimeters or anything else, there's nothing written on the diagram. What I mean is, there's nothing written next to 96 or 100 telling me that there's some special unit. So in this case, I write units as my unit. Another example. Now this one gives us some extra information. So we're determining our third side. They say write your answer in surd form. So we're going to talk about what surd form means. Some of you may already know. Then use a calculator and round off to two decimal places, and we know how to do that. Okay, so we're labeling our sides A, B, and C like before. We're going to use our Pythagoras statement, A squared plus B squared equals C squared. But then because this triangle is called triangle DEF, I have to be very specific with my Pythagoras statement. So I need to substitute in the specific names of the sides, and you know that this is where you get your marks. Don't forget the reason Pythagoras. Substituting in and simplifying, we end up with DF is equal to the square root of 181. When you put the square root of 181 into your calculator, it doesn't give you any simpler answer. So this is what we call a surd. And if you remember from our very first lesson, a surd is any irrational root. So any irrational root like root 3 or root 7 that doesn't simplify down to a whole number or an integer. Meaning this root is the simplest form it gets. If you put this in your calculator, you're going to get a non-terminating, non-recurring decimal. Now it says then round off your answers to two decimal places. So then I press SD in my calculator. SD in my calculator. And they give me the long decimal, which I round off to two decimal places. In this case, the question asked both for surd form and for two decimal places, so these both are my answers. The last example, this is similar to what you're going to do in your homework in exercise B. In triangle MUN, angle M is 90, and then we have two side lengths. So we need to determine the unknown third side. Now it's very difficult to do this without a diagram because we need to be able to see where these side lengths specifically are. So So my first step is to draw the diagram. I'm going to draw a 90 degree triangle, and they tell me that angle M is the 90 degree angle. So I'm going to draw in my 90 degree box and label it M. I then have this side MU, so this is coming off of side M, which is 93. So I'm going to choose one of the other vertices to call vertex U, and that side is 93. Then the other one has to be N just by default. So label our sides with their lengths, 93, and NU is the hypotenuse, which wasn't obvious from the statement without the diagram. Determine the length of the unknown side. Again, we're going to label our sides A, B, and C, and use the theorem of Pythagoras like we did before, substituting in, and we get our answer of 124 centimeters. If you didn't quite follow that, I suggest that you pause the video, copy it down, and make sure that it makes sense to you. Okay, you're now ready to tackle our homework exercise for today. Exercise 1A, very similar to the first two examples that we did in this video. In B1 and 3, this is where you need to draw the diagram. And C1 and 7, these are the questions related to surd form, and then you round off. If you need a refresher about how to round off, I've given you a little diagram here, the rounding coaster. But there's also a nice another Math Antics video that you can watch as well.